Hi, Jesse here with Metroline Direct. In this video, I will be showing you what it looks like to allow a Rescue Assist technician to connect to your computer. So you'll get to see step by step what's involved. We connect all the time to customers' computers to help them program their phones and phone systems. And while it's not necessary for us to connect remotely, it can be very helpful sometimes. Rescue Assist is a new option by LogMeIn, and they also bring you GoToAssist. And if you aren't familiar with GoToAssist, you might want to check out my other video on that. Just like I've said in that video, make sure that you do not allow anyone you don't know to connect to your computer. There are a lot of scams going on where people receive calls out of the blue with someone claiming that they need to help you fix a problem or a website that says the same thing. Don't fall for that stuff. Okay, so the first thing you will do is open up your web browser. I'm using Chrome in this video, but it would work in other modern web browsers too. You're going to go to the website address www.fastsupport.com. I recommend typing it into the address bar, which is the top line on your web browser, not a search engine or a search bar that you might have at the right. And when you start to type something in, a lot of times the web browser will start to try to complete it for you. Make sure that you're choosing fastsupport.com or www.fastsupport.com. Either one should work. Make sure it's all one word. You don't want to type in fast support by itself because then it's going to take you to a search engine. And there's nothing wrong with the search engine. It's just you just want to make sure you're getting to the right website. And it's faster if you type it in completely so that you don't have to look through the search engine options. Once you get to the website, you'll notice that it redirects to fastsupport.gotoassist.com. And so if you're at the right website, it will look like this. You'll notice they have the Be Cautious advertisement at the top of the screen. And it will ask for your name and support key. I'm going to put in Bob here. The support key would be given to you by the technician either over the phone or it can be emailed. And then just click on Continue. So the first thing you'll notice in your web browser is that it will show the name of the technician that is connecting to you. If it's your first time connecting with Rescue Assist, you'll see this little notification window at the top. Console.gotoassist.com wants to show notifications. I recommend clicking on Allow because later on you'll see that this will allow you to see chat messages coming from the technician, but it's not necessary to see the chat messages, and I'll show you later on what I'm talking about. So I'm going to click on Allow here for right now. Next, you'll see a yellow Download Application button towards the bottom of your web browser. Give that a click. On the bottom left corner, you'll see a big yellow arrow pointing down to the file that you need to click on once it's finished. Just a quick side note, if you're using Internet Explorer or Edge, you're going to see the file downloaded at the bottom in the middle here. Just click on Run on that. Or if you are using Firefox, click on the green arrow and then click on your file there. And they do tell you here that this session is being recorded for quality control. And that's it. We're connected. So I'll give you a quick overview of what you can do here. Of course, at any time, you can end the session by clicking on End Session here or here. And then the technician will no longer be able to see or control your computer. Okay, so if the user being connected to wants to send the technician a file, this little button right here is the Send File button. Just click on that, and that will let you browse in your computer to select the file that you want. And the technician can also send you a file. Now let's look at chat. So let's say something happens to the phone conversation. You know, in most cases, you would probably be communicating over the phone. But let's say you need to be able to chat. They've got the chat here. This window in the middle functions as the chat window. Pretty simple. But let's say we minimize this because we're working on something else. And then the technician sends me a chat. So what's going to happen to that chat is if you clicked on Allow Notifications earlier, like I told you, then you'll see that chat pop up on the bottom right corner of your screen. Just like that. And let's say I want to bring that chat back up. I can just click on that, and it'll take me right back to the chat window. So like I said, you don't need to allow notifications, but it can be very helpful sometimes. So now you know what to expect when a Rescue Assist technician connects to your computer. Don't forget to check out my video on GoToAssist. If you liked the video, please let us know by clicking the like button. Share this with people you think it will help. And if you want to be notified of more videos when they are released, click the subscribe button. Thanks for joining us.